as a busy surgeon like you, I have these compression hose on my feet here. Because my feet are starting to swell at the end of the day as I get older. What's going on with that?
Well, you have a very common condition. And in fact, more than 50% of people over the age of 50 and roughly 70% of people over the age of 70 have a condition called venous insufficiency. And so that's what's going on. And basically what is happening is, just as you alluded to, those low pressure veins, the low pressure system in the body, when we stand erect all day, we're putting an incredible amount of pressure on those veins, and the blood tends to pool in our lower extremities. From a teleological standpoint, our lower extremity venous system was not made for us to be upright as much as we're upright.
Gotcha.
And so we have these little bitty valves in the veins that we depend upon a great deal to push the blood or propel the blood toward the heart. And over years and years of that pressure, they tend to wear out. And so when you get into your 50s and 60s and 70s, it's not uncommon for us to see those valves wearing out and the blood pooling. And that causes the swelling. It causes the fluid in the tissues. And that's why at the end of the day, your feet swell. Mm-hmm. When you go to bed at night and you resume a recumbent position, then when you wake up the next morning, most of the time, all of your swelling is gone. Now, your compression hose actually are like an exoskeleton compressing the tissues, and they tend to keep blood from pooling. They tend to keep fluid from accumulating in your tissues. And so we do prescribe an awful lot of compression hose. And actually, I wear compression hose, having turned 60 recently. I'm actually 61. And so I wear those hopefully to head off any issues that I might have with the venous system. But you're talking about the venous system.
The venous system. So if we're getting a little older, we've got some swelling, compression hose is a very practical thing that almost anybody can do. As long as it's not cutting off circulation, why not, right? And I found the good ones cost more.
Yeah,
you get what you pay for.
Exactly, that's exactly
with compression hose.
They come in a lot of different levels, and so we do prescribe different levels. For most people, a level one or two is very sufficient.
Gotcha. These are actually rated in millibars. There's like 20 to 30. I don't know what the units
is,
but actually there's a rating on these.
That's exactly right. So up to 15 to 20 millimeters of mercury.
That's what it is.
Is a one, compression level one. And then 15 to 20, 15 to 25 is usually a two. And then above 30 or so is usually what we would rate as a three. Now, the threes are for people with severe problems. They're, and when I say severe problems, I mean chronic swelling of the limb, skin changes associated with that, hemosiderosis, which is a darkening.
What is that? It's a darkening?
It's a darkening of the skin. And in fact, what happens is, as you accumulate fluid in your tissues, you're going to accumulate some red blood cells in there as well. And remember that the heme molecule has iron in it. And so when you break down the iron molecule, it's a brownish discoloration. And that's called chemosiderosis. It's a brownish staining of the skins. And the other thing that happens with this whole process is that in the subcutaneous tissues, you get this inflammatory process that takes place. And if you palpate the tissues of the leg of someone who's having this accumulation of fluid and scarring process, it will feel very abnormal to you. It's not the nice, soft tissues that you're used to feeling.
A firmness or something?
Very firm. Sometimes associated with even a redness in the acute phases, as we've said, this brownish discoloration. So some people describe that as almost the feeling of a hide,
like a leathery
sensation.
Feeling.
Yes.
So if somebody notices that might be something to go to you about.